Now, scared for their futures, devoid of hope. Hardly what you'd expect to hear from youngsters who are just starting out their working lives. But a new study shows today's 16 to 25-year-olds are the unhappiest generation in a decade, and it's having a massive impact on their well-being, with half experiencing a mental health problem. Sky's Olivia Kinsley reports.
In an Easter tutorial group, these A-level students' biggest immediate worry is their upcoming exams. But life beyond the classroom also plays on their minds a lot.
I've had counselling in college about stress management, because I have let it get the better of me at times.
I want to do well, and I want to do my family proud. That's always been a big thing for me.
Fears about job prospects, money and not being good enough are leading young people to feel anxious, even hopeless, according to youth charity The Prince's Trust. In their survey of more than 2,000 16 to 25-year-olds, 61% said they regularly feel stressed and 47% that they've experienced mental health problems.
This year's survey paints a picture of a generation of young people who are increasingly anxious, uncertain and pessimistic about their future. More than half of the young people in the survey said they often or always felt stressed and anxious, and a quarter actually said they feel hopeless on a regular basis. We think this is a real cause of concern, not just for those young people, but for the whole of our society.
Psychotherapy counsellors Rizwana and Deborah say life today throws up all sorts of challenges.
They're not building their confidence through mixing with people in real life terms. They're mixing with people and their peers 24/7 on social media, and that's unsustainable, it's unrealistic, and it doesn't help them form real bonds, real relationships where they can work through issues of friendship.
These students certainly recognize the extra pressures of social media.
It adds extra stress because it's you want to live that life, even if that's not their life. So it's very misleading and it doesn't help at all.
At school, you're expected to do things right, and if you don't do it right first time, then you're taught how to do it, and you need to practice failing because things won't go right in the real world.
At Justin Craig Tutorials, pupils are encouraged to switch off from study after class. Seeing friends and not piling pressure on themselves will be essential for coping with life after A-levels too. Olivia Kinsley, Sky News.